This presentation is to help you get started using Tolcap. It guides you through the steps of an analysis and tries to give you the sense of the questions you need to address to get a process capability prediction. An introductory presentation addressed why you would use Tolcap. This one explains how. But first, when do you use Tolcap? If you're a designer, use Tolcap from the very earliest stages of the concept design. You're probably sketching out some fundamentally important features, and these elements will doubtless give rise to certain key dimensions where the required tolerance is not negotiable. You don't need a formal engineering drawing to know this. So at this point, and thereafter, whenever you're about to specify a tolerance for a vital dimension on a part, use Tolcap and check for process capability before you get stuck with a design with problems. If you may be a quality engineer, and you want to check why a problem feature is proving difficult to make, does the problem go back to the design? Use Tolcap to see if there's likely to be a process capability issue. How does Tolcap work? Process capability of a tolerance dimension depends on the manufacturing process to be used, the material and the geometry of the part, and the state of the tools and machinery and the capability and maybe the past experience of the supplier. It sounds a complex interaction, and it is. But Tolcap leads you through the main factors to a good working estimate of process capability. The prime factor determining the process capability is the manufacturing process. Parts are formed by such process families as forming. Forging is hitting parts with a hammer to deform them plastically into shape. Machining, turning is cutting pieces of swarf away from a rotating bar. Casting or moulding involves melting the material, pouring it into a mould and letting it refreeze. The point is that these processes essentially come down to physics, and the process capability that is ultimately achievable depends on how well an experienced manufacturer can control all the variables to get the best out of the basic physics of the process. Tolcap incorporates capability maps for a variety of manufacturing processes. The maps plot dimension against specified tolerance for each process. The diagonal lines on the maps are lines or sometimes contours of constant process capability. The higher up the map, the higher the process capability. To use Tolcap, log in and select the map for the manufacturing process for which you're designing. Let's suppose this is turning and boring and it's in the machining group. Enter the dimension and the tolerance of interest, 100 millimetres and 0.035 plus or minus. I'll do that even if the drawing shows 100 millimetres minus 0 plus 0.07 because Tolcap does expect a balanced plus and minus tolerance. Next, click Calculate. You will see numerically and graphically a predicted process capability, CPK is 2.35, and where you are on the map. So far, the process capability estimate is for the best a competent supplier should achieve in the ideal case. Just thinking again about the physics of the process, the properties of the material being processed will have an effect: hardness, malleability, thermal expansion coefficient, and so forth. Where there's a strong interaction between the process and the part material, Tolcap provides alternative process maps for groups of common materials. For other processes, the prediction from the standard map is modified by a material to process factor MP. This is probably a good time to click the View All Processes link to see which processes are for specific materials and which are not. There are several groups for injection or compression moulding for various plastics, for example. For turning and boring, there is an MP wizard button. Click on this and the drop-down arrow and select a material, in this case, mild steel. No, you don't need the precise specification of the material, and should your material not be shown, you can select one with a similar relevant properties. Click Update Chart. And notice the decrease in predicted CPK to 1.95, which is still quite acceptable. Next, we consider factors loosely related to the geometry of the part. Click the GP wizard. And we are presented with several questions. These may vary with the process we have selected. First, we are asked how many planes we are machining at one time. Are we perhaps facing while turning? Next, is the part long or slender? It's more difficult to hold tolerances than for a squat, sturdy part. Let us suppose our part is long and slender, and so we select answer B. Does the part have repetitive features? Such processes as gear hobbing. And here it could be relevant if we were turning a series of grooves which we wanted to be identical. Are there extra setup operations? Let us suppose we have to turn our part around to bore this feature. So we select one process, and then we would click Update Chart. And we see the effect of the slender part and turning it round is to reduce CPK prediction to 1.5. And we still have to consider some additional factors. Click the VP wizard. And we are presented with some more questions. We would hope the manufacturing machinery is up to date and well maintained. The feature geometry may be at limits of feasibility, or the part may be at the limits of size or weight, too big or too small. Suppose our part is not only slender, it's long, so it's large, near the capacity limit of the lathe, and we answer yes to the question, and we press Update Chart. And notice that the CPK has fallen to an unacceptable 0.97. Well, that's a tear-up then. Maybe, but not yet. Okay, we're predicting a low CPK, but we know the factors that cause the low value. The part is big, and it's long and thin. Let's take the result to the supplier and discuss the problem first. Okay, the part is near machine capacity. Is that a real problem? Does it matter? Is there a similar sized part in production? The part is long, but can it be supported in the middle, or maybe held in some sort of collet, so that the part is supported and the problem eliminated? Positive answers here, backed up with data from the process on similar parts, will allow us to go back to the analysis and get a better prediction. This presentation hopefully leaves you ready and confident you can start using Tolcap. If you're still puzzled, try using Tolcap anyway, it may make sense. Or go through this material again, or see the next presentation that gives some more explanations and an alternative, simpler approach to product process capability prediction. Thank you for listening. For more information, visit www.tolcap.com.